Hi everybody, how you are doing? Good day to you. Welcome back to another video on my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Blessing and you're welcome to my Blessed Am TV. In this video, I want to share with you the gory confessions of an IPOB commander who was caught over the week. And he has confessed to their activities in Imo State and how they have been wreaking havoc and wasting human lives. So yeah. In his confession, he said that Nnamdi Kanu asked them to use 2,000 heads to bury one of the commanders that was killed during the operation in the time past, and so far they've been able to get about 30 heads. He also said something about them using virgin little girls as chems for fortification. I mean, the details are just very gory. And also in his telephone and the things they got from them, there were gory videos of the actions and their, you know, attacks that they have carried out, and how they also go in and take people that they call saboteurs. And in fact, there's one of the videos that, like, is just unbelievable what they did with the man that they even caught his pee. And I can't share those videos with you guys, but I just want to share the details of the interview he gave to the Nigerian police. I think he's doing this in the hope that he gets some kind of amnesty, you know. So yeah, this is the video. Let me know what you think. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and yeah, I'll see you very soon in another video. Bye for now.
Good day, Mr. Onyami. How are you doing?
Thank God, sir.
All right. It's been a while. We have been hoping to have this video interview with you to better understand the activities of Eastern Security Networks in Imo State and Southeast region of Nigeria as a whole. We had also hoped to have this interview with your colleague, Mr. Dragon, but he died while attacking the police headquarters, Owerri, alongside other Eastern Security Network members. I understand you are fully cooperating with our national security investigation. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have volunteer statement and other interviews to this effect. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we appreciate your cooperation so far. However, we would like to know more about your activities and that of other leaders of Eastern Security Network in Imo State and in the Southeast region, as earlier stated, at least a comprehensive view of activities you have participated on and what you can inform us about. So with that, we'll commence this interview. For the record, what is your name?
My name is Samuel Benjamin Ozamo.
How old are you?
I'm 38 years.
Where are you from?
I'm from Ogun local government in Zambia.
Okay. Are you married?
No, sir.
Do you have children?
No, sir.
Okay. What is your educational qualification?
Secondary school.
Okay. Did you complete?
No, sir.
What level did you stop?
I stopped at SS3, but I not took WAEC.
Okay, did not take WAEC?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Emery Uzoma Benjamin.
Yes, sir.
You are not obliged to say anything to the police in respect of our national security investigation unless you freely wish to do so. But whatever you say shall be recorded in this video interview and will be preserved as evidence and may be tendered in a court of law. You understand what I just said?
Yeah, okay.
Do you give your consent? You agree make police do this interview?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell us, why were you arrested by the police?
I was arrested by the police because I am ESN member, sir.
What is the meaning of ESN?
The Eastern Security Network.
Okay. Who is your leader?
It's Mazin Andikal.
Okay, thank you. When did you join Eastern Security Network?
I joined Eastern Security Network in 2019.
Who introduced you?
It's one Mr. John from Muguta government in Cambridge.
Okay, are you still in contact with him?
No, sir.
Okay, where were you trained?
I was trained in Niger State, Delta State, after the
river. Is it Niger State?
Delta State.
Oh, yeah.
After Niger Bridge.
Okay, you mean Niger Bridge?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Do you recognize those who trained you? Can you tell us who trained you?
No, sir.
Who are the people that trained you there in the place?
Is the leader that brought them from? I don't know where they brought them to train us.
Okay, very good. All right. Who are the leaders of Eastern Security Network in Imo State that you can tell us about?
It's Temple and Engineer Mike. And the senator, and me, myself, Ozoma, and Dragon and the baby and some of the our members.
Okay. You are called Onyami. Were you a member of Nigerian Army at any time?
No, sir. It's when I finished secondary school, I started buying army form. That's why the people started calling me Onyami.
Okay, but you were never enlisted in Nigerian Army before?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. You were mentioned by one Chima Obinneche in his video interview on how you and others trained him to become a member of Eastern Security Network. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, in your opinion, are the revelations made by Mr. Chima Obinneche in that video interview correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell us, how many Eastern Security Network operations against security agents and civilians have you participated in?
It's more than 20, sir.
Okay, during these operations, like how many people would you say you people have killed?
It's more than 30, sir.
Okay.
Can't make sure the.
Okay. Okay, there are more than 30. We understand. Okay, can you estimate for us how many security agent rifles you people have collected?
More than 50, sir.
Okay, about 50 or more than 50?
About 50.
Okay, good. All right, who is this rifle with and where are they kept?
The rifle is in our camp in Atlili with Tempo.
With Mr. Tempo?
With others.
Okay. You informed our National Security Investigation that on the night in Kosovo hideout was stormed by security agents. You were in the same house with him, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
We are curious to know, how were you able to escape?
Escape from the backyard gate, sir.
From the backyard gate?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Since the account with Nkonso, like how many operations did you have you people gone that you participated in?
It's more than 7, sir.
Okay, can you give us like some?
Governor's house and the our mama. And at Lily side, let's call it that village. Engineer is engineer that took us to.
Which engineer?
Engineer Mike.
That took people there.
It's in his village. He's the one that took us there.
Is that the place people cut somebody's hand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. You told us that or better still, since it was announced on social media by Nnamdi Kanu that Late Nkosuo will be buried with more than 2,000 heads of innocent Nigerians.
Yes, sir.
By the Eastern Security Network.
Yes, sir.
So far, how many people have been murdered to achieve this purpose?
More than 30, sir.
More than 30 people have been killed?
More than 30,
Okay. Around May this year, Eastern Security Network members attacked Olu Police Station. Did you participate in that attack?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how many were you that or in all that?
We are more than 30, sir.
Can you name the leaders of that attack?
It's Mr. Tempo and Engineer Mike and Milzama and Zuma and Dragon and some of our members.
Okay. Which vehicle were you in?
I'm in Siena.
You're in Siena. Whose vehicle was Tempo in?
Tempo was in Hilos, Mr. Mike was in Hilos, but Tempo, I could not remember. The
okay, which vehicle is the Dragon in?
The Toyota Camry.
Toyota Camry. How many rifles did you people use for that attack? What's the color of the Toyota Camry? That
red.
Dragon?
Red. Red, yeah.
Okay. How many rifles did you people use in the attack?
It's about 30 rifles.
About 30 rifles? Are you certain? There are 30, you people came with 30 rifles?
No, like 20. It's not all of us that was carrying rifle.
It's not all of you that was carrying rifle.
Yes,
so I'm like, how many carry?
Like 20 rifles, sir.
You were carrying a rifle?
Yes, sir.
What type of rifle did you hold?
AK.
AK-47?
Yes, sir.
Okay. On that particular attack at Olu Police Station, you people lost some members, right?
Yes, sir.
How many died?
About 12 of our members.
Okay, 12 of your members died?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So from where did you people gather before you came to that place?
We gathered at our camp in at Idato side.
Okay.
Idato.
Okay.
Not on Dizog side.
Okay, thank you very much. And after the attack, where did you people go?
We went to our camp in Lili.
Lili. Okay. Alright. You informed detectives, that is, you informed our National Security Investigation that before the Eastern Security Network go for any attack, they used to fortify themselves with juju charms.
Yes, sir.
And those charms are used for protection against bullets of security agents. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And that on this particular attack at Olu Police Station, about 10 heads belonging to young ladies, human heads belonging to young ladies, was used to prepare the charms. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Please, where did you people get the heads of these young ladies that you used?
From Imo State, sir.
From Imo State, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, whose idea was it to use human heads to prepare chance to fortify you people from bullet wounds?
Mr. Engineer and the Temple.
Who is Mr. Engineer?
Engineer.
What's his name?
His name is Engineer Mike. I don't know his real name.
Okay, thank you very much. But in your own opinion, would you call the attack on Olu Police Station a success by the Eastern Security Network?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you. You also informed our National Security Investigation that IPOB and Eastern Security Network has sponsors both locally here in Nigeria and abroad, and you are ready to identify them for us. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
You also said that you identify the houses and camps where your ECN leaders and members are staying. Is that correct?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. During your arrest, you appeared surprised that security agents were able to successfully arrest you, and you even resisted by fighting with them. Why was that?
Well, I thought that it was I would avoid to collect people's phone and run away. I thought it was because the man was not with security uniform. That's why I started fighting him.
Yes. Okay, and you sustained little injuries, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, well, now that you have been arrested, is there anything you want to say for yourself or for your leader?
I want to say for my leader, Mazinan Dika, let him come back and fight for the freedom. I want to say for the federal government.
Wait, freedom of who?
For his people.
Okay, he should come back to Nigeria and fight for the freedom of his people.
Yes, sir.
Okay, continue.
I want to say to the federal government to please forgive me and give us amnesty. Will not do it again and give us a second chance.
Where is your leader?
He's in other countries.
Okay. How do you communicate with him?
We don't communicate with him, sir. It's through radio.
Through radio?
Yes, sir.
Any of your senior leaders who communicates with him?
Yes, sir.
Who? Like who do you think?
Chinua Samorida.
And who again?
And the engineer Mike.
Okay, they normally communicate with him. Okay. Okay, we appreciate your cooperation so far with this investigation and granting us this interview to assist us in our investigation. Please, if there's anything you remember you want to share with us again, just let us know so that we can document it in a video interview.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Onyami, a.k.a. Emery.
Benjamin
Uzoma. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. All right.